हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक. आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड वेल एट योर होम. सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ वेरी न्यू टॉपिक फ्रॉम योर बुक. एंड द टॉपिक टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज मनी. नाउ यू मस्ट बी थिंकिंग दैट मनी. सो द वेरी फर्स्ट थिंग विच कम्स इन आवर माइंड इज मनी इज समथिंग कॉइन्स और नोट. बट नो, द एक्चुअल डेफिनेशन ऑफ मनी इज एनी ऑब्जेक्ट or a record that is generally accepted as payment for goods and services and repayment in a country. So in a country, whatever things or goods are being exchanged for the goods and services, that is called money. The Indian currency which we are using right now is Indian rupee, also written in the form of INR. So that is Indian rupee. Now students, you must be thinking that a question which arises here is, what was before money? What we were using when the money was not there? That means we don't have coins and rupees. So that time the system which we use was barter system. The system was barter system. To barter is to exchange goods without involving money, because that time money was not evolved. Now in barter system, we give some goods to one person and in return we take something else. So that is an exchange of goods. For example, if one person has a good which is something useful to some other person, then he gives the good and take it back in return to some with some other goods. Now the point is why money was invented. So there was a very important reason behind it, that when we are exchanging the goods, that time the amount or the quantity of goods or the quality of goods was not same. So in that case, many of the peoples get into a quarrel that no, my goods are of more value and you are giving me something which is less valued and something like that. So in that case, we people decided to make something which is equal in number, and that will be called as money. Right? Now here comes some drawbacks of the barter system because of which money was evolved. Very first, no double coincidences of wants. Second, no specific unit of value. That means there was no fixed number of values that for particular things, what are the things should be exchanged. No specific unit of measurement. Nobody can measure that how much the cost of my goods and how much is the cost of the good which I am exchanging with my goods. At the same time, inability of divisibility of goods. And the last, the most important thing was the inability to transport goods. Maybe the good is very big in size, so that's why it was not so easy to transfer it from one place to another. So, because of the drawbacks of all these reasons, we have developed a new condition of living, and that is money. Money which is required for our living. Why it is required? Because we can purchase, we can sell or buy goods with the help of this. Now, the money which we are using nowadays are basically consist of two things: coins and rupees. As you can see on the board, that we have coins and rupees which we are using as money. Now let us know something more about paisa and rupees. A paise or rupee are unit of measurement of money in India. If I talk about India, so yes, we are using for the exchange and purchasing of the goods, that is money in the form of paise or rupees. Now if we discuss about various types of coins which we were using in our ancient time, since our ancient time, that is 1 paisa, 2 paisa, 5 paisa, then 10 paisa, 20 paisa, 25 paise, 50 paise, 1 rupee, 2 rupees and 5 rupees, along with that 10 rupees. But out of these all paises, some of the paisa are not being in use nowadays. Right now, the kind of paisas which we are using is basically 25 paisa, which now even also not in use. So right now what we are using is basically a 1 rupee coin, 2 rupee coin, 5 rupee coin and a 10 rupee coin. So these are the money which are present in the form of coins. Along with this, we have some more currencies which are in the form of notes. Note means a piece of paper which have some value. So the notes which we are using nowadays is 1 rupee note, 2 rupee note, 5 rupee note, 10 rupees note, 20 rupees note, 50 rupees note, 100 rupee note, 200 rupee note, 500 rupee note and 2000 rupee note. So these are the different kind of paise and notes which we are using, or you can say these are the different kinds of coins and notes which we are using nowadays. Now here comes, when we talk about this rupee and paise, so there comes a relation between these two. So what is the relation between paise and rupee? So yes, the relation here is 1 rupee is equals to 100 paise. 1 rupee is equals to 100 paise. The same term can also be said in different way, that 100 paise makes 1 rupee. Clear, students? Now let's take some example. If it is said that you have to convert 5 rupees to paise, so how you are going to convert? So as there are 5 rupees and 1 rupee is actually equals to 100 paise, so in that case what you will do, you will multiply 5 with 100 and it will give you 500 paise. That means 5 rupees is also equals to 500 paise. Similarly, if you have to convert 650 paise, that is given in paise, into rupees. So now since you have to convert paise into rupees, that means you will divide it by 100, because 100 paise makes 1 rupee. So as we will divide 650 by 100, you will get rupees 6.50, or you can also call it 6 rupees and 50 paise. So this is all about money.
So students, after discussing about money and the basic conversion, in which we have studied that there are 100 paise in 1 rupee, or we can say that 1 rupee is equals to 100 paise. So now we will do some of the book exercise questions which I have taken from your book. The first question says, convert into paise. Now the first value is rupees 39, and we have to convert rupees 39 into paise. So very first, as you all are aware, that what is our key point? 1 rupee is equals to 100 paise. 100 paise. That means, so if I have to convert rupees 39 into paise, what I have to do? I will do 39 multiplied by 100, and that will give 3900, that is 3900 paise. Right? So when you have to convert rupees to paise, multiply by 100. Okay, always remember, rupees to paise multiply by 100. Similarly, the second one, rupees 93.18, and we have to convert it into paise. So that will be 93.18 multiplied by 100. Now whenever multiply this number by 100, the two of the decimal, that means this decimal which is after two places from the right, will get removed. That means it will give 9318 paise, because these two zeros will get removed by the two decimal places. Similarly, the third one, where you have to convert rupees 11.43 into paise. So once again, it is 11.43 multiplied by 100. Once again, since there are two decimal place values, so once again, the decimal will get removed. So our final answer will be 1143 paise. Or we can say that 1143 paise. Clear, children? Always remember, whenever you have to convert rupees to paise, multiply by 100. Now, what will be the opposite of that, if we have to convert paise to rupees, then we will divide by 100. So taking the second question, which is related to that only, in which the money is given to us in terms of paise, we have to convert it into rupees. First part, 2569 paise, and we have to convert it into rupees. So here, what we will do, 2569 divided by 100. Now, divided by 100, since there are two zeros here, that means in the given value 2569 paise, we have to put a decimal after two places from right side. After two places, that means after 9 and 6. So, two places are here. So, the next step I will be writing it, rupees 25.69. Here, when you have multiplied by 100, the decimal get removed, the two places were removed. Now, when we are dividing, we have to put a decimal after two decimal places. Always count this two decimal place value from the right, not from the left. Similarly, the second part in which you have to convert 50,239 paise into rupees. So once again, it is 50,239 divided by 100. Now, two zeros decimal after two places from right side. 1, 2. That means our decimal will come between 2 and 3. So I will be writing it as rupees 502.9. The same answer, which is rupees 502 and 39 paise, can also be written as rupees 502 and 39 paise. Rupees 502 and 39 paise. Sometimes you might have seen in decimals also using this point, and sometimes you might have seen this way. So, I hope conversion from rupees to paise and paise to rupees are clear to you. Rupees to paise multiply by 100, paise to rupees divide by 100. Clear, children? Now, let's take some of the fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks, and the first part says 102 paise and convert it into rupees. So 102 paise, paise to rupees, divide by 100. Divide by 100 means decimal after two places from the right side. 1, 2. It means our answer will be rupees 8.02 paise. So our answer is rupees 8.02. Then rupees 27.95 into paise. So it is rupees 2 paise multiplied by 100. So, multiplying by 100 will actually remove the decimal place value. So, it is 2795 paise. 2795 paise. Third one, 8000 paise. 8000 paise, we have converted into rupees. Paise to rupees, divided by 100. Dividing by 100 means decimal after two place values. Two place values means after these two zeros. So, we can write it as 80.00. Last, 1685 paise into rupees. So that will give you 16.85 paise. Or you can say that would be 16.85. Okay, children. So today we have done the conversion of money from rupees to paise and paise to rupees. I hope today's lesson is clear to all of you. Thank you for the lesson, students. Have a great day.